The first programming assignment is to implement some operations on a singly linked list. Altogether, we have to write six functions. The first one, create a singly linked list. Each time, insert a new node after head. Second function, create a singly linked list. Each time, insert a new node at tail. The third one, reverse a singly linked list in place. And fourth one, merge two ascending linked lists. And the fifth one, delete all old elements in a singly linked list. And the last one, print or display the linked list. Of course, you have to write a function main to call all the above functions to write a complete C program. Okay, let's first see a running demo and to make clear how the program works. I write the C program in Devil C because the software is relatively small and easy to download and install. I install it in Chinese. You can install it in English version. First, compile and then run the program. The first function is to create a singly linked list LA. Each time we insert a new node after head, first input length of the list, suppose it is 4, and then in ascending order, input 4 integers, for example, 5, 2, 5, 7, 8. And then a singly linked list is created. Elements in the list are in descending order because each time we insert a new one after head, and then press any key to continue. The second function to create a new singly linked list LB. This time we insert a new node at tail. Similarly, input size of the list, suppose it is 5, and then in ascending order, we input 5 integers, and then a singly linked list LB is created. Elements in it are in ascending order, and press any key to continue. Next function is to reverse LA in place. After reversing, elements in LA also appeared in ascending order, and then press any key to continue. Next function to merge or combine two singly linked lists LA and LB to get a new list LC. Here, one thing to pay attention. If we have two records with the same value of data field, then we only keep one copy of it. Press any key to continue. Next function, delete all elements in LC with old data fields. If the number is old, delete the records. After deleting, the singly linked list LC looks like this. We have only even records left, and then the program finish, terminate. Let's introduce idea of implement each function. The first one, InsertAtHead. Actually, we have discussed the function in detail in our courseware. First, generate a header node, and then each time create a new node and insert it after the header. Suppose the new node p points to, then piece next is assigned with L next, and then L next points to P. After the first round, the first record 2 has been inserted after the header, and the second round create a new node and then insert it after the head. P next points to L next. L next points to P. Repeated N times, and then a singly linked list in descending order will be created. Actually, you can find the first algorithm in our courseware PDF. Realization of the second function, insert at tail. First, create a header node and define a pointer where points to it. Where always points to the current tail of the singly linked list. Initially, it points to header. And each time we generate a new node, suppose P points to, and then insert it after current tail. Where's next points to P, and where moves to P. Then in the second round, generate a new node again. Insert it after tail. Where next points to P, and where moves to node P. And repeat. After it is repeated, M times. And a singly linked list records are in ascending order is created. Actually, we have discussed this function in detail, and you can find it in our courseware PDF. Next, output and display the singly linked list in the following format. First, output a character H, and then output the data field of each records. Declare a pointer points to the first node in the list, and then along the next links, traverse all the records in the list and output a data field of each element until we reach the tail of the list. This function is very easy for us to realize. Next function, reverse list. Reverse the descending singly linked list LA to an ascending order in place. So-called in place means we are not allowed to generate new nodes. We have to use the nodes in LA, modify their next pointer fields, and after reversing, records in LA are in ascending order of data fields. Here, we introduce one implementation. Of course, you can design your own algorithm to realize reversing. Here is one demo. First, define a pointer points to the first node and the next field of the header assigned to now. Each time we insert the node P points to after the header. Of course, we have to record the node after P. Otherwise, this one will be become a wild node and no longer be located. And insert P after L, we have to modify two pointers. P's next is assigned with L's next, and then L next points to P. After two pointer fields have been modified, P is inserted after the header. P moves to P, and similarly, Q moves to the node after P. And then the second round, insert P after the header L. P's next points to L's next, currently L's next points to 8, and then L's next points to P. After these two pointers be changed. P is inserted after the header, and then P points moves to P, Q, and Q moves again. P's next points to L's next, and L's next points to P. Each time, insert a new node after the head. After the head, actually, it is an application of the first function insert at head. And then P points to Q. Q moves forward. P's next points to L's next. L's next points to P. And P points to Q. When Q and P are now, then the algorithm finish. Actually, we have to traverse all the nodes in the list after reversing. The elements are in ascending order. Time complexity for this algorithm is linear to n. Following this idea, you can write the algorithm by yourself. Next function, merge list, combine two ascending singly linked list LA and LB. The new list pointer LC points to. We are not allowed to generate new nodes. And if there is one node no longer in use, we have to release the memory allocated for it. Here is a running demo of this algorithm. Suppose this is the first ascending list, and this is the second one. We want to merge these two singly linked lists. We declare two pointers, PA and PB, points to the first node respectively. And then the header pointer LC points to LA. And then we declare a new pointer PC. Actually, it is a tail pointer of the new singly linked list. This algorithm is an application of the second function, insert at tail. Let's see how it works. Each turn, combine the data field PA points to and PB points to, and insert the smaller one after the tail of PC, because currently the node PB points to is smaller. Then insert this one after tail PC. PC points to PB, and PC moves to PB, and then along the links, PB moves one step forward. And then the second round, compare data field PA points to and PB points to. This time, the record PA points to is smaller. Insert the smaller one after the tail PC. PC points to PA, and PC moves to PA. PA along the links moves one step forward. Repeat. Compare the node PA points to and PB points to. This time, PA points to. The node is smaller. Insert after the tail. PC points to PA, and the PC moves to PA. PA moves forward. Compare again. Currently, the node PB points to is smaller. Insert after the tail PC. PC's next points to PB. PB points PC points to PB, and the PB along the links moves forward. Compare again. This time, the node PA points to and PB points to have the same value of data field. Then we only keep one copy. We only keep one node. Suppose the node PA points to is used insert it after tail PC. PC is next, points to PA. PC points to PA. And then PA moves one record forward. And then before PB moves forward, this node should be released because we don't need to use this one anymore. So we declare a pointer points to it. And then PB moves to the node after it. And then release all three the node T points to. And then repeat. Compare data field of two records. And this time, the node PB points to is smaller, link 8 after the tail PC. PC is next, points to PB. PC points to PB. PB moves forward. And then compare again. We have two records with the same value of data field. And then this node is used, and this one should be released. PC is next, points to PA. PC moves to PA, and PA moves one node forward. And then this node should be released. T points to it temporarily. And then PB points to next. And then free the node T points to. This will be repeated until either PA or PB has reached the tail of the list. In our example, PA first reached the tail. Then we have to link the remainders in list LB after PC. So PC's next points to LB. And another thing we need to do, because this header node is no longer in use, so release it, and then the algorithm finish. We can redraw the singly linked list after merging. All the elements are in ascending order, and if we have two records with the same data field, we only keep one copy. Following this idea, you can write the algorithm. Of course, you can design different algorithms to realize merging, and the time complexity is linear to m plus n. Suppose m and n are size of the two lists respectively. The last function, delete all records. If the data field is an odd number, and then display the singly linked list. Let's see how this algorithm perform. First, because it is a singly linked list, so we declare two pointers. PRE points to the head node, and P points to the first node. Each time, we track the data field of the node P points to. If it is an odd number, the node should be deleted. Its predecessor's next field points to P's next. Release node P points to, and then P points to previous next. Check its data field again. If this time it is an even number, then PRE points to P. P along the links moves forward. Check the data field again. If it is an odd number, the node P points to should be deleted. Previous next points to P's next. Release the node P points to, and P points to previous next. And track it again. Still, it is an odd number. The node should be deleted. Its previous points to P's next, and free p. P points to prayers next. Check again. This is an even. So pre and p moves forward together. Pre points to p, and then p points to its successor. And then this one is an old number. Deleted. Pre is next, points to p is next. Free p, p points to previous next. If it is an even number, then pre points to p. P moves to the node after it. It is still an even number. Pre points to p. P points to the node after it. When p is now, means it reached the tail of the list, then the algorithm finish. We can see after deleting all the old numbers, data field of each records are an even number. You can write the algorithm by yourself. Of course, after we have realized all the above six functions, we have to add a function main. And then in function main, we call the above functions, and then we complete a C program. Okay, I think you can write the programming assignment by yourself.